Welcome to the e-learning platform by ScienceSpark. So today we are going to learn about properties of a magnetic field. This topic is from standard 7th and it covers chapter number 19 from SSC board. So let us see what we are going to learn today. So we'll just revise about magnets and the materials that made of magnets. Then we'll also see why people say Earth is a magnet. Then we'll also see magnetic field of Earth. Then we'll learn about magnetic compass, which is used to search directions. Then we'll learn about induced magnetism, and in the end we'll see that why repulsion is a true test of magnetism. Right. So here we have three materials, iron, nickel and cobalt, which are magnetic. Yes. So friends, these three materials are the ones from which we can make permanent magnets. Right. Okay. So as we know that these are magnetic materials, so we can make magnets out of these. But friends, do you know? You can use different combinations of materials to also make magnets. We'll see which of those, if combined, can be used to make magnets. So one such mixture of different elements, also called as alloys, is nipermag. So it is made up of four elements: iron, nickel, aluminium and titanium. So you can see briefly the presence of iron and nickel as magnetic materials makes it possible to make this alloy magnet. Then we have a second alloy called as alnico. This alloy actually is vastly used to make magnets. As you can see in the picture, this magnet is also an alnico magnet. So as the name goes, it is made up of three elements: aluminium, nickel and cobalt. So friends, here I have a needle stand and a needle. Now I will place these needle over the stand. Now as you can see, the needle is moving and it will be stable in certain direction. Now if I try to move this needle, and let's say I want to make this needle stable here, but it doesn't. It again comes to the same direction. Now if I have to move this magnet, I will have to do it by hand, or I can blow air, or I can bring another magnet near it, because this needle is also made up of a magnet. Yes, as you can see, now this needle is stable in other direction because there is a magnet present near it. If I remove this magnet, it will again be stable in the same direction. Why is it so? Yes. So friends, now let me do this experiment at some other place. Let's say if I go outside India and do this experiment, it will show me the same direction. If I go anywhere in the world and perform this experiment, it will give me the same result. Now you must be wondering, which direction is this? If you go outside in daytime and find out the direction with the help of sun, you will come to know that this direction is north and south. So this needle is stable in north-south direction. And as I have told you, if you go anywhere in the world, this needle will be stable in north-south direction. So there must be a magnet like this somewhere in the world, due to which this needle is stable in one particular direction. Now where that magnet could be? Any guesses?
Yes. So the magnet is present inside the earth. Yes. And due to that magnet, all these needles are stable in north-south direction. In fact, if you take any magnet and if you suspend it will be stable in north and south direction. I'll show you that. So here I have a stand and a bar magnet. So I'll place this magnet like this and I'll suspend it freely. So as you can see, now it is stable in a direction. It is due to the Earth's magnetic field. It is moving, but it will be stable in one particular direction, and that is north-south direction. And hence we say that magnet has two poles, north pole and south pole. And as you can see in this magnet, red color usually represents north pole and blue color represents the south.
Right, so this is a magnetic needle, and as you know, if we keep it suspended, it always aligns itself in the north-south direction. Now, if I bring a bar magnet near it, it will change its direction and it will align itself according to the position of the bar magnet. So as you can see, the south pole of the bar magnet is near the north pole of the magnetic needle. As you know, north and south pole of different magnets attract each other. That is the reason the needle now has aligned itself in another direction. Now, if you just take the magnet away, the needle will again align itself in a north-south direction. Now, why is it so? So, what I think is this is because of another magnet which is aligned in this specific north-south direction, due to which this magnetic needle is aligning itself in that direction. So where is that magnet? Yes. So here we have our Earth, and this is the north pole axis or the north-south pole axis around which our Earth rotates. Now we have the north pole at the top and south pole at the bottom. And in the middle of the Earth, if you can revise, we have a big huge magnet. It is not a physical bar magnet which is present inside the Earth, but there is a magnetic field around Earth like this, from which we can say that there is one big huge magnet inside the Earth. The axis of that magnet is slightly tilted from the axis, the rotational axis of Earth. Now, the north pole of a freely suspended magnet, as we know, settles in the direction of the geographic north pole of the Earth. It means that the south pole of some gigantic magnet must be near the geographic north pole of the Earth, that is represented by blue color. And the north pole of that magnet near the geographic south pole of the Earth, represented by red color. Right, now there was a scientist named William Gilbert. He inferred from this that Earth itself is a gigantic magnet. Right? However, the south pole of this magnet must be near the geographic north pole of the Earth, while the magnetic north pole is near the geographic south pole. Slightly confusing, but just remember that if you suspend a magnet freely, the north pole of the magnet points in the northern or the north direction. Right? Okay.
Friends, we have seen a magnetic needle with the stand. We have also seen an experiment with that. And we have deduced that Earth is a magnet. The needle which we had used in that experiment is also called as magnetic needle. Magnetic compass, which shows us the directions, is actually made up of that. So here, I'm going to show you how you can do this at home. I have taken a piece of foam which usually floats on water. You can also use a piece of thermocol if you have one. Then I have used a magnetic needle. Now, if you don't have a magnetic needle, as we have seen earlier, you can use a nail and you can magnetize it by rubbing the magnet on it. Then you have to place this needle over the foam sheet. If you are not so sure about the placement of the nail or any needle, you can use the cello tape to fix it. Now, I'll just keep this assembly over water. Here I have a bowl full of water and I'm just going to place on it. And as you can see, it is deflecting. And it will finally align in north-south direction. Hence, you can make a magnetic compass at home.
Right, so here we have some U-pins and an iron strip. So if you bring that iron strip near the U-pins, will it attract the U-pins? Well, the answer is no, because there is no magnet, right? The iron strip is just iron. It is not made magnet. So let's make magnet out of that iron strip. For that, we'll need a bar magnet. So just hold the bar magnet on the top of the iron strip, so that the iron strip will now attract the bar magnet. And as you can see, if we bring now the iron strip near the U-pins, it will attract the U-pins towards itself. Now, why is it so? Magnet is on the top of iron strip and U-pins are attracted to the iron strip. Yes. So friends, this is called as induced magnetism. And if we just remove the bar magnet, at that moment itself, the U-pins will fall down. So we conclude that whenever the magnet is touching any magnetic material, the magnetic material becomes magnet for temporary period of time. For the same period for which the magnet is being touching the magnetic material, right? So as I told, this is called as induced magnetism. So now we will see why we say that repulsion is a true test of magnetism. So we have a bar magnet and we have the unknown material. Now we have to find out that unknown material, whether it is a magnet or not. So let's consider that unknown material to be non-magnetic. So it won't attract the bar magnet, right? So it is a non-magnetic material. But if in case it does attract, then it could be a magnetic material or a magnet. Now, magnetic material, as we know, will attract a magnet, of course. And if that unknown material, south pole is facing the bar magnet, it will attract the bar magnet. Because north pole of that bar magnet is near the unknown material. So there are two possibilities. So how we could find out? For that, you have to just rotate the magnet by 180 degrees, just flip it over so that now the south pole will be facing the unknown material. And if it still attracts, then surely it is magnetic material. Because magnet will attract magnetic material from both the directions, right? And if it repels, then surely it is a magnet. Because we know that when two similar poles or two like poles of different magnets come near each other, they go far away from each other. They repel each other, right? Hence, we say that repulsion is a true test of magnetism. So friends, let's summarize the session. So in the beginning, we have seen magnets and from which materials they are made. Then we saw why Earth is a magnet. Then we have also seen the magnetic field of Earth. Then we have seen magnetic compass. We also learned that how to make temporary magnets with the principle of induced magnetism. And in the end, we found out that how repulsion is a true test of magnetism. So friends, here are some questions. Kindly note these questions in your notebook and write the answers to them. Thank you.